All right, Shalom. First and foremost, I want to give all praise to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem Rahakwadash, Yahweh being the name of the Heavenly Father. His name is Yahweh. That's how you pronounce it in the ancient Hebrew. Okay. The creator of the heavens and the earth. Okay. And his son's name, Bahashem, meaning in the name of. In the ancient Hebrew as well, Yahweh Shai. Yahweh Shai is how you pronounce the Savior's name, who most people unwittingly refer to as Jesus Christ, but we know that that is not his real name. It is Yahweh Shai, who is the only begotten Son of the Heavenly Father, okay? So when you praise him, or call upon his name, you would say, Kol Halam Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai. Okay. Double honors to the apostles and elders, a great millstone who taught me this truth. My name is Malak, and I'm here with the In the News. Okay. Because today is third, if I'm not mistaken, all right, of February. Oh, Salakia, it is the 4th of February, okay? And every day, hey, we get into the closer to the end. Every day is a day closer to the end of the downfall of this society and closer to the kingdom of heaven, where the Israelites will be in rulership, all right? And what we have here is a whole lot of folly, all right?
Weight 350 pounds eats free in Heart Attack Restaurant. Weight 350 pounds eats free in Heart Attack Restaurant.
Hey, man. This is what we get in the last days, man. You got lines, motherfuckers with masks on, going to Heart Attack Restaurant. And you get a free meal if you are over 350 pounds, man. Literally can't make this shit up, man. Look, man, they literally are forwarding death, man. Like, man, that's extreme folly, right? Like the scriptures say, okay? This is Ecclesiastes chapter 10, okay, verse, we'll start at 5. There is an evil which I have seen under the sun, as an error which proceedeth from the ruler, all right? Because the world is not ruled righteously, okay? It's ruled in error, right? They've gone away from the scriptures. I mean, they were never, this society was never based on the true meaning of the scriptures, okay? Only what they were prophesied to do, which is to be a prison unto the Israelites and to afflict our people. But this society hasn't forwarded any type of righteousness. All right. And it all comes from their ruler, which is ultimately Satan. All right. Verse 6, folly is set in great dignity, and the rich sit in low place. And the rich is the Israelites, especially, the ones with the rulership mentality. OK. The elect. Right. Specifically the men. OK. Because that's who the Lord is dealing with on that high level. All right. Now the Lord he's dealing with sisters as well, but those are few and far between. But if this is specifically the men, okay? Because contrary to popular belief, it will be the men under Yahweh Shai. All right, the order will be the Yahweh Shai and then his men who are going to lead and have dominion in the kingdom. All right, it ain't gonna be, you know, the woman over the man. All right, but I know I'm going kind of on a diatribe, but yeah, man, folly is set in great dignity, as it says, right? You got the damn the heart attack. What is this called? Heart attack cafe, man. You weigh 350 pounds, you get to eat free, right? That's foolish, right? They don't like, man. Straight up folly. You literally can't make this up, all right? And she thinking she gonna eat free. And you just embarrass yourself. All right. Let's get this one first. All right. Okay. So look, it say record number of robots joined US workforce last year. Okay. So this is from RT News, a post. We'll read some of this. It seems our robot overlords are more than happy to do minimum wage jobs before they take us over. The US saw over 40,000 robots pitch in to help out with labor shortages in 2021 at a cost over $2 billion. Not only that, but they're also starting to diversify their skill sets, taking on roles in the e-commerce and food industry. Yeah, man. These robots, what we're seeing here is the implementation of the, I believe they call it the fourth wave of the industrial complex revolution, something to that degree. All right, something to that matter, right? Basically, it's just a fancy way of saying you damn humans aren't worth shit. y'all take sick days, you gotta go to the bathroom, you stinking up the bathroom, man. You come to work damn near, you know, barely on time, and your breath stinks. So we gonna get these robots, man, to do the minimum wage jobs, cause y'all aren't worth shit, man. Y'all just useless eaters, man. they don't need you no more. All right, these elites, they're about to trim down. Okay, they got robots to do your fast food jobs. Okay, the cross state truck driving, you know. They got robots to do all these low-level jobs. They don't need you anymore. So what are they going to do? Since you're a debt slave, right? They're going to cut costs by cutting you off. You know? That's what they're going to do. All right? So just more, you know. You know, and what is this also going to lead to? The grinding shall cease, as it says. All right, you're not going to be able to. There's not going to be as much work out here, and ultimately, that's going to lead into more sorrows for you, average Americans. All right, because you have this psychosis, okay, which is pervasive in America. In American society, is you give a man his job, and he doesn't have an identity out of the outside of that job. he takes on the role, he or she, because, you know, men and female are in the workforce, but ultimately it's pretty much the same thing. They end up taking on the role and that job is their personality now, right? So yeah, man, you're just going to have a lot of people out here when they fully implement this, you know, AI and, you know, takeover, I'd say, right? You're going to have a lot of people out here that are going to lose their mind. They're not going to have a purpose, man. They're literally going to be like no need for them to be living. So what, suicide rates go up, depression, alcoholism, all sorts of things, right? Domestic violence, right? So, man, hey, you people, man, y'all really finna feel the wrath of Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai, okay? Because these elites, man, they're going to implement this new world order, all right? It's here. Yeah, actually, I'm gonna get this, okay? Because that's kind of this kind of yeah, man, we're just gonna get to it. See that? You see that, man? Look. Hey, this is how the world, this is what you get. All right? This is the world, right? Beautiful America, okay? The glorious city, right? Babylon the Great. Is trash, all right? This is LA, right? San Francisco. Man. And that's, you know, that's just one portion of it, man. You know, that's where you go anywhere, man. It's like, shit, it just, everything stinks, right? It's just trash everywhere. Homelessness is at an all-time high. Okay, because, hey, believe it or not, the earth is mourning. The people are languishing. What is that? I think that's how you spell languish. What was I say? Actually, let's get this in the blue letter. Y'all bear with me, okay? But yeah, man, the earth is languishing, okay? The people are depressed and you know, the people are mourning, right? We'll just get to the point. This is Isaiah 24:4. The earth mourneth and fadeth away. The world languisheth and fadeth away. The haughty people of the earth do languish. Verse 5. The earth also is defiled under the inhabitants thereof. Because they have transgressed the laws, changed the ordinance, broken the everlasting covenant. And yeah, bro. That's what you see. The earth is mourning, and it's slowly, day by day, fading away. The spirit in Babylon the Great is fading away. All right, people aren't trusting as much as they used to in this society. It's slowly becoming a third world country, man. Now, if he was to just take that and then not have that big ass LA branding on the damn video, you might have thought and seen that little Range Rover drive by. Hey, man, you might have thought that that was somewhere in India, in the East India. No, man, that's in America. That's in the greatest city in the world, right? That's what it's come to. No, man, that's this place is fading away. The haughty people, haughty is just a you know, an old English word for pride. The proud people of the earth do languish. Let's get this word languish. That's a strong word. It's it's what Amal. Okay. Some of the other words that it's, you know, translated into is feeble and weak. It says to be weak, to droop, to languish, to be exhausted. Man, everybody's exhausted. We all tired. Tired, man. Everybody, every last one of us, man, tired. Can't never get rest. You always gotta be somewhere. Everywhere you in a rush hour. Every hour is rush hour, man. To be weak, to droop, to grow feeble, to languish. Okay, let's just get it in the dictionary. To lose vigor and vitality. Okay, pretty much, you know, just synonyms. I just wanted to get to it. But yeah, man, the earth languish. It languish, right? The haughty people do languish. All right. Just a few of the things that are going on. Now, this is an article from End Time Headlines, which is a great website for news. They constantly be bringing out news that pertains to the end times, because that's exactly what we're in, okay? What we're in. This is an article that was published today. It says, South Carolina continues to reel from earthquakes as 18 quakes have been registered since beginning of 2022. An earthquake with a magnitude of 1.3 took place 3 miles east of Elgin, South Carolina on Wednesday, as confirmed by the U.S. Geological Survey and the South Carolina Emergency Management Division. It was reported that the aftershock occurred at 12:39 a.m. This earthquake took place 6 days after the 17th one had been reported in the England and Lugoff areas on January 27th. It had a magnitude of 3.3, which was felt by many residents in the area. SCEMD stated that this is the 18th earthquake to occur in the area since December 27th, 2021, the 19th to happen statewide since then, and the 12th to occur in 2022. The first earthquake in Eglin was the strongest, rating at a 3.3 scale. Yeah, man. So a lot of earthquakes happening. Listen, 18, they say what? 18 since the beginning of 2022 in South Carolina, man. Now, doesn't that sound like a kind of strange place for an earthquake to happen? I mean, South Carolina, are they really known for earthquakes like that? I mean, can y'all brothers, I mean, I don't ever remember hearing about South Carolina just known for earthquakes like that. Maybe I'm bugging out. Somebody leave a comment and just, you know, if y'all ever lived in South Carolina, just let me know if y'all began earthquakes like that. But it's a kind of sounds like a diverse place for an earthquake. Maybe. Somebody help me out with that. This is Matthew chapter 24, verse 6, and ye shall hear of wars and rumors of wars. See that ye be not troubled, for all these things must come to pass. But the end is not yet. For nation shall rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom, and there shall be famines and pestilences and earthquakes in diverse places. All these are the beginning of sorrows. These earthquakes is only going to get more and more common. The pestilence, the sea bug, okay? The famines, right? It's only going to get more common. These are the beginning of sorrows. All right, let's see. Let's get this word beginning just to get to it, man. Says the origin, the person or thing that commences, the first person or thing in a series. Amen. That's pretty much it. That's the only one that really pertains to the subject, right? Yeah, man. That's really the only one that pertains to it. But yeah, we got earthquakes going crazy, right? Hey, man, this is exciting. We at the last days, man. And we got this guy, right? Look at this guy. You already know what's going on with him. This dude looks like a damn, like he lives under under a damn bridge, man. This is an article written today as well, February 4th, 2020, by RT News. Okay. Professor stripped of contact with students over pro-child blank remarks. Stephen Kirshner, sounds like a small hat. You know what they into. Well, we going, hey. Stephen Kirshner said it was not obvious to him that blank sexual contact was necessarily wrong. A New York college professor who made remarks in favor of blank between adults and young children has been stripped of contact with students and banned from campus as the college's investigation continues. The State University of New York at Fredonia launched an investigation this week after video clips of philosophy professor Stephen Kirshner defending blank went viral online. Okay, and you know, a lot of y'all brothers, there's a couple of brothers that went to university or that has even, you know, look, man, this, the truth, it is very philosophical as well. And some of the philosophical ideals, they intersect. Okay, but when you go into the philosophy and you know the various great philosophers who the modern day philosophers reverence, and you look into their life, like Plato and Socrates and various other philosophers, I don't necessarily know a good amount of them, but when you look into their life, hey man, they were really about this big P word, right? They were into that man boy love, okay? That was big in those cultures. They believed in that, right? And in these modern day, don't get it twisted, man. These modern day philosophers or and philosophy majors, this is ultimately morally, they believe that this stuff is right. And it's not a small number of them. You'd be surprised. You'd be surprised at how many people, you know, these big wigs up in you know, the upper echelons of New York, and these high corporations, these who you would consider very, very intelligent, highly respected people, they believe in these, in this philosophy. They agree to it, right? And what is ultimately that? That is that wine, right? That wine that got the whole earth drunken, the philosophy, okay? Which ultimately, that tells you too, that this is Rome all over again, okay? Because when you study, when you get into, you know, when you're at these universities, hey man, that's all that they teach you about is the philosophers from that same time period, right? The Plato, the, you know, I'm sure y'all know what I'm talking about, man. All those philosophers, they generally come from, right, the Greco-Roman time period, okay? Right when that beast was being brought back, right? The Renaissance era, right? And y'all can read the rest of this, man. It's just making me, this kind of making me mad, man. That's why these devils need to get up out of power, man. This has to stop. You know, we personally know brothers with kids. I don't have none, but I personally know brothers with kids, man. And this is what they're trying to teach the children is okay. All right. Because Esau is, hey man, that nigga nasty. It's a nasty dude, man. This is Job chapter 30, verse 1. But now they that are younger than I have me in derision, whose fathers I would have disdained to set with the dogs of my flock. Right? Because Esau, man, you give him a dog, you don't know what he's doing with that dog. Fuck, he's nasty, man. Job said I would have disdained to have set with the dogs of my flock. Right? Because he's big into that weird, the very lewd sexual acts. Okay, bestiality, that P word, right? Man, this dude is a super freak. The elites, right? And as the rulers, we know as the rulers, as the rulers is, so is the people, right? So these people are bugged the hell out. That's why we gotta flee from Babylon, man. Mentally, man. Cause you're not gonna be able to find comfort. You don't know who some of these people that you see on that screen, who they truly are. Some of the people that you've looked up to at some point in time when you were in the world, hey man, you don't know who they really were or who they are. This is, okay, getting into the juicy things, right? What's really gonna bring this society down? Let's get this title, okay? It says, from February 3rd, so yesterday, it says, NATO says Russia to have 30,000 troops on drills in Belarus, north of Ukraine. All right, so we got war drums coming up. These are some pictures of the tanks That's what they're known for too. Russia has a lot of, I think they called them infantry, but basically it's just a word for, I don't know if I'm pronouncing the word right, but basically what I'm trying to say is they have a lot of big metal weapons, okay? So things such as tanks, big old Soviet Union buggies, you know, a lot of fighter jets. They're really known for, and also submarines is something they're really good at, or they were really proficient in and advanced in. All right. We just had a submarine go completely unnoticed that had nuclear capabilities come up undetected on some, I forget which coast, I believe it was the East Coast of America, but they completely, you know, came undetected on the East Coast of America, man. They're you know, they're playing, they're going through a certain war, you know, practices and routines, man. Simulations, I'd rather say, okay? And America didn't even detect it. We'll read a little bit of this article, and then I'll show you, the viewer, the contrast of what NATO's doing, because this is what Russia's doing. They're sending, you know, they're sending 30,000 troops to Belarus, okay? Practicing military exercises, okay? Now, this says, NATO said Russia had stepped up deployments to Ukraine's northern neighbor, Belarus, in recent days, and was expected to have 30,000 troops there for joint military exercises this month. The Russia-Belarus exercises, running until February 20th, have provided Moscow with cover to further increase forces near Ukraine at a time when the United States and Britain have warned that Moscow may be gearing up for war. Right? So, I mean, that's a big number, man. 30,000 combat troops. Oh, look at this. Matter of fact, we'll read this last paragraph or, you know, sentence. This is the biggest Russian deployment there since the Cold War, with an expected 30,000 combat troops, as well as Spetsnaz Special Operations Force, Su-35 fighter jet, S-400 air defense system, and nuclear-capable Iskander missiles, he said. Man, look, that's like Keisha, right? Keisha taking off the damn earrings, man. they getting ready to do damage, man. Biggest Russian deployment there since the Cold War. Look, man, and there's already been talks of Russia having, what was the term they was using? Oh, staging an attack, okay? Right? So they have a pretense, right? And we ultimately know through the scriptures that the least of the flock is going to draw them out, the least of the flock being Israel, right? But the Lord, ultimately, what I'm trying to convey to the audience is that, hey, the Lord is putting hooks in the jaws of Russia. Man, he's turning them back into their old, that old Soviet spirit is being put back on them, all right, to be ready for war. And that's exactly what they're doing. This is Ezekiel chapter 38, verse 4. And I will turn thee back, or we'll start at verse 3, and say, thus saith the Lord, Yahweh, behold, I am against thee, O Gog, the chief prince of Meshech and Tubal, Gog, right? Gog and Magog, That is the land of Russia, all right? When you look into it, if you search up Gog and Magog land, the land mass that they have, had dominion over is the land of Russia today. That's what it would be known as, is Russia, okay? It says, and I will turn thee back and put hooks into thy jaws and will bring thee forth and all thine army, horses and horsemen, and all of them clothed with all sorts of armor, even a great company with bucklers and shields, all of them handling swords. All right. So, yeah, man, they're clothed in armor, bucklers and shields. Okay. The most infantry military equipment moved since since the Cold War. Look at that. That's a damaged weapon, a tank. Not there just to look good. It's not a artifact that goes in the museum, man. These are war actual weapons, weapons of mass destruction. All right. Now, on the other side, you got a day before this. This is what NATO is doing. All right. Look at these guys, man. The mighty men, all right, says UK, this is an article from RT News, February 2nd, okay. UK halts army training for Inclusivity Day. Tens of thousands of British troops will pause drills to reflect on their differences. UK soldiers will spend 6 hours undergoing group talks and lectures focused on culture and inclusivity within their units next Tuesday, all focused on getting the 82,000 strong fighting force to think differently. Amid a complete stop to normal training, the order was reportedly issued by General Sir Mark Charlton Smith, blah, blah, blah. Let me see. We'll just read, just bear with me. We'll read these last two. Basically a paragraph says, okay. It is not the army being woke, it is the army addressing some of its unacceptable behaviors. An army spokesman told the Daily Mail on Tuesday, insisting that we identify that we are on a journey and a change of culture. Takes time, and this season is part of that journey. Right? No, man, this is, it's gonna be a big change, okay? However, not everyone in the military is pleased with their use of their time, especially as tensions in Europe continue to run high between the U.S. and its NATO allies and Russia. So this is what they're doing with their time. They're having meetings on culture and inclusivity, and trying to think differently. All right. So, this is what they're that's what NATO is doing, while Russia is they're training their men to be strong, right? This is 2nd Ezra chapter 9. We'll end out on this. Okay, it says, he answered me then and said, measure thou the time diligently in itself, and when thou seest part of the signs past, which I have told thee before, then shalt thou understand that it is the very same time wherein the highest will begin to visit the world which he made. Therefore, when there shall be seen earthquakes and uproars of the people in the world, then thou shalt well understand that the Most High spake of those things from the days that were before thee, even from the beginning. For like as all that is made in the world hath a beginning and an end, the end is manifest. Even so, the time also of the highest hath plain beginnings and wonders and powerful works, the endings and effects and signs. Everyone that shall be saved and shall be able to escape by his works and by faith whereby ye have believed shall be preserved from the said perils and shall see my salvation in my land and within my borders, for I have sanctified them for me from the beginning. Then shall they be in pitiful case which now have abused my ways, and they that have cast them away despitefully shall dwell in torments. For such as in their life have received benefits and have not known me. And they that have loathed my law while they have had yet liberty, and when as yet place of repentance was open unto them, understood not, but despised it, the same must know it after death by pain. Okay. So chapter we continue to go into. All right, I know I read a mouthful. But yeah, we are at the end of the end. Okay. We see the signs. All right. We see the people are in an uproar. The nations are in an uproar. All right. But we also are going to, we're going to start to see and already are seeing the wonderful works and signs of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai making himself known. Okay. So it is very important in this time to make sure that we are on point, speaking to myself first and foremost, because that is the only one that I have control over. Amen. Because you know, we've started. You know, we gotta finish what we started, man. And the more that I do, the more that you do, right? The more you know, the closer we are coming into the kingdom. Okay. There's gonna be a time where, you know, we get low in the spirit, but hey man, we gotta keep pushing. Okay. So I just wanna read this section of 2nd Ezra chapter 9 one more time, and then we'll close out. Okay. Hopefully it's been edifying. All right. And this is 2nd Ezra chapter 9, verse 10. For such as in their life have received benefits and have not known me, and they have loathed my law while they had yet liberty, and when as yet place of repentance was open unto them, understood not, but despised it, right? That's what we don't want to be. We don't want to have that place of repentance and despise it, okay? We need to constantly repent for things that we do daily. You know, the sins we commit willingly and unwittingly. Okay. We, you know, don't want to get caught asked out, because it says, it continues to read on. It says, the same must know it after death by pain. All right. We want to come out and receive that crown of life. All right. So hopefully this lesson has been edifying. I want to give all praise and all honor and all glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem Rahakwadash, which is the name of my Heavenly Father. Yahweh being the Father, Yahweh Shai being the Son and Savior of the nation of Israel. Shalom to the hopefully elect, the men making their bodies a living sacrifice for this truth. Shalom to the Akwath, the sisters holding the household down. All right. Peace and salutations.